we're gonna do a little YouTube video here, a little vlog. So obviously we're at the Barcelona game. I don't even know if you can hear me. Let's talk business real quick, okay? Let's talk business. So, the number one component of you doing business is trust, okay? We all know that. It's following you up all the time. You gotta be trustworthy. But what does a trustworthy individual actually look like? What are characteristics that a trustworthy individual holds? What do they have? Well, I'll tell you this. Trust, oftentimes people think of trust as, oh, somebody they can count on. Correct, but let's backtrack. Okay, somebody you can count on. Does that mean you necessarily like them? No. Does that mean that people shouldn't like you in business? No, they should. But think about that for a second. Somebody that you can count on is someone you trust, right? You trust them to do the job. Now, for example, you may not like your captain, right? On the football pitch, okay? Or soccer pitch for all my fucking stupid Americans out there. You may not like your football captain, okay? You might not like him. But if you trust him to get the job done, then you trust him, right? If he's holding your team accountable, he's gonna make sure that you guys get the job done. You trust him to get the job done. You trust him to lead your team. Now, you may not like him, but you trust him. So why? Well, that person holds, okay, and has the characteristics of somebody who's a trustworthy person. They're accountable, they're hardworking, they're disciplined. Okay, they're a leader. So what of those characteristics of a trustworthy person are you missing in your business? How trustworthy are you, right? Like, if you look at someone, you can look at some of the people around me. You can tell right away which of them is a trustworthy or untrustworthy individual by the way they carry themselves. Somebody walks like this, you probably wouldn't trust them to lead your team or to lead your company or to lead them in your entire acquisition. So why are you walking around like this? Why are you on sales calls like this? Why is your Instagram profile look like this? Be like this. Like this. I'm in the middle of a fucking Barcelona game and I'm out here making a YouTube video. I would hope you think that, man, this guy's got a bit of balls, right? I'm sitting here talking to a fucking GoPro. I'll probably look crazy, right? But these are some of the characteristics that a trustworthy person holds and has. Is somebody that's confident, somebody that's courageous, somebody that's passionate, somebody that's brave. You see, being courageous isn't doing something in absence of fear. It's doing something in the present time of having fear. It's doing something while having fear. That is the definition of a brave, courageous person. It's doing something even when it's scary to do it. It's not doing something when it's not scary. That is not courageous. That is not brave. It's courageous or brave to do it when you know it's hard to do. This, not necessarily easy to do. I don't think many people would be here saying, talking to a GoPro. It takes a bit of courage, but who cares? I don't give a fuck with these people. They'll never see them ever again. So why can't they think that I'm filming a YouTube video? 10 years ago, go watch my YouTube channel. I never would do this. I'd never film like this. I'd be so scared. But now, I don't care anymore. I don't give two shits. Because when we all die, these guys aren't going to be thinking about this guy that held a GoPro. And if they did, well, fuck, that's pretty cool. Right? Pretty cool for me. So when you die, would you really be happy that you lived your life the way you did? Would you be content? Would you be complacent? Would you be happy with the way you live your life? Or would you wish you had done more? I guarantee you wouldn't sit there on your deathbed regretting the things you did, but you'd regret the things you didn't do. I can guarantee you I won't regret recording these YouTube videos despite everybody looking at me. But I can guarantee you I would regret not recording it. So I hope that this serves, okay, while the sun's going down, while people are screaming, while the Barcelona match is about to start back up at halfway, that this should inspire you in some way, shape, or form to become a better, more confident, passionate, courageous, brave person than you are right now. Because at the end of the day, who gives a fuck? Live your life the way you want and start carrying and acting as if you're the main character, because guess what you are? So many times you're the producer, you're the editor, you're the director, you're the creator. You are the everything of your own movie, and you're also the main character. So you get to decide how you want to live it. Voucher.
What's up?
You have anything to say?
Live your life, man.
There you go. We're fucking living right now, right? Like, we planned, I went to Europe. I landed, I think, in Europe 5 days ago. I texted Voucher, I'm like, yo, man, we gotta do something cool. And we're like, okay, fuck it, what should we do? We're like, well, we can go to Barcelona. We're like, fuck it. The next day we booked, 3 days out, we booked tickets.
3 days.
And then as we booked, he's like, yo, you wanna go to Barca again? Sure, and now we're here. Because we're just living life, we're just doing it. We're just fucking living life. And I guarantee you, we won't regret this. Well, we would have regretted not doing it. So go out there, live your fucking life, man. Life is good, life is awesome. Hola. Come on. Just beautiful, man. Beautiful life. Hey, love y'all. Have a great day. And remember to be the best version of who you are. Go out there and get what's yours. Live a life filled with purpose. You owe it to yourself to be great. Peace.